published 1731 EDT, 26 October 2017 updated 1731 EDT, 26 October 2017 Arsenals AGM turned into a farce on Thursday with bumbling chairman Sir Chips Keswick unable to control the room. The 77-year-old buffoon infuriated around 200 shareholders at the Emirates Stadium by refusing to answer relevant questions in a preposterously disdainful manner, telling one to write in if you have a problem. Another who asked whether owner Stan Kroenke was going to speak was told by Keswick to read the newspaper. Arsenal chairman Sir Chips Keswick left with director Josh Kroenke and CEO Ivan GazidisA. A couple of other bewildered Arsenal fans were told their questions were just statements, when everyone apart from the idiotic Keswick knew what they were asking. Keswick, who has proved an even worse AGM chairman than his incompetent predecessor Peter HillWood, which is really saying something, suffered the embarrassment of the vast majority of shareholders in the room voting against the resolution to reappoint him and owner Stan Kroenke's son Josh to the board. But as the resolution enjoyed 97% support from proxy votes, the two resulting ballots were a waste of time. When Sir Chips, who owns no shares in the club unlike the Arsenal faithful to whom he had been so dismissive, brought a premature halt to the proceedings, he was slow and clipped out of the room. Arsenal deserve a better leader than Sir Chips, who is past his Selby date. Keswick has proved a worse AGM chairman than his incompetent predecessor Peter HillWood, FA's beleaguered technical director Dan Ashworth, whose position has been labeled untenable after the Mark Sampson fiasco, is getting away from the pressure surrounding him by flying to India to watch England play Spain in the Under-17 World Cup final tomorrow. The unprecedented success of England's junior sides may save Ashworth from the sack. England technical director Dan Ashworth has flown to India to cheer on England's under-17 sit. Is beyond belief that yet another Carabao Cup draw turned into what the Football League themselves described as an utter shambles. This time the quarterfinal draw, due to go out live on Twitter at 4 p.m, was delayed for more than an hour by a minor technical glitch. When it was eventually streamed by Twitter at 5:45 p.m, it had to be shown pre-recorded rather than live as promised, and there were graphics errors. The social media giants, supposedly the future of live TV football rights, are a long way from broadcasting a 90-minute match if they can't put on an AGM draw. As for Football League chief Sean Harvey, who claims the credit for the Florida's botched attempts to take the draw to new audiences at home and abroad this season, how many more mishaps will his 72 clubs allow him to preside over? A question of sport team captains Matt Dawson and Phil Tufnell were waiting to do the draw. Current thinking is for the England team playing Germany at Wembley on November 10, the eve of Remembrance Day, to wear the poppy emblem on armbands. But after all the fuss in getting FIFA to finally accept the symbol honors the war dead, rather than being political, surely it should be on the shirts, as Premier League teams do. Twickenham debenture holders are angry over their shoddy treatment when buying tickets for the Barbarians game against New Zealand on November 4. The RFU directed them to Ticketmaster when tickets went on sale, but the agency were charging £95 plus £7.50 delivery for seats inferior to their normal debenture positions. Recent purchasers have managed to buy £75 seats direct from the RFU, who had said previously their only role was in hiring out the ground. An RFU spokeswoman said the Barbarians were still in charge of all ticket arrangements. Twickenham debenture holders are angry over their shoddy treatment when buying tickets. Warner, the former chairman of UK Athletics who did most to bring the 2017 World Championships to London, is returning to a supporting role as the new chairman of the British Equestrian Federation. The Belgian Franck's low profile is sure to rise under the outspoken Warner,